गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल हैव सीन आवर लास्ट टू वीडियोज ऑन जीएसटी, इन विच वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट वॉट डू वी मीन बाय जीएसटी, वॉट आर द बेनिफिट्स वी आर गेटिंग आफ्टर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ जीएसटी, एंड वाई वी इम्प्लीमेंट जीएसटी वैन वी ऑलरेडी हैव ए लार्ज नंबर ऑफ टैक्सेज ऑलरेडी दैट इम्पोज्ड ऑन अस, देन वाई वी नीड अ न्यू टैक्सेशन ऑल्सो. So, in last videos, we have discussed about objectives of GST, in what circumstances we need registration of GST, registration under GST. If I am a seller, what should be my minimum turnover for registration under GST, that we discussed. And what are the slab rates of GST, categories of GST, that we have discussed. In some cases, we have reverse charge also in case of GST. And we have to reverse that back in the account of the purchaser. In some cases, we have to receive back also GST, but not from government, from the seller whom we are purchasing goods. Then we have discussed about the value addition, that we need to pay GST to the government only on the value that we added in our cost for our profit purpose or whatever. For the value that we added, we need to pay GST on that. So after all of these important points, we have discussed about what are the items that are not come under the GST. They have separate taxation policies for them. Now today we will start how to implement GST in our journal entries, because it is the important for our accountancy, that how to implement GST in our journal entries. So today we will have an question on GST to put that into the journal entry, how to charge GST from purchase also and from sale also. So first we have entry of purchase goods in cash for 5000 and we paid GST and SGST at the rate 9% each. 9% each here they given, it means the slab rate is 18%, because 9% we will pay to the central and 9% we will pay to the state government. So ultimate cost we will get 5000 plus 18%, that much amount that we need to pay to the seller. So how we post entries of GST? First is we need to put date. April 3rd we purchase account debit, purchase goods in cash. In question they clearly mention that we are purchasing through cash, so we will use cash, purchase account debit. How much we paid for that? 5000 value of goods we purchased, then we paid GST also on that we called input central GST and input state GST, account debit, account debit to cash. Now what the amount of GST that we need to pay? First thing is we purchase goods of the value of 5000, then we need to pay a 9% GST to central government and 9% GST to state government, because they mentioned that we need to pay each, so the slab rate is 18%. So we need to find the 9% of 5000, that is 450. So 450 will go to the central government and 450 will go to the state government, and the total amount that we need to pay, that is 5900. In this entry what we have done, that we purchase goods of worth as 5000, then we paid a input CGST of 9% of that amount. 9% of 5000 is 450 to central government and 450 to the state government. So we given 9% GST to each, that is central and state government, and the total amount that we need to pay is 5900 to the seller. So in this case we purchased goods worth as only 5000, but when we paid GST on that, because it is an taxation, we will add that also in our cost if when we sold these goods further for resale purpose. But now how much amount we need to pay? That is 5900, not 5000. Although we are purchased good only for 5000, but taxation we need to pay to the seller. That is also our responsibility. How so? In case of purchase, we got the credit, that is input credit. When we sold these goods to someone, we will charge him GST and we will set off that GST against this input GST. Next thing is sold goods for cash 8000 plus CGST, SGST 9% each. Now also we have the same slab rate, that is 9% each for central and state. And now we are selling goods. So for selling goods, April 5, in case of sale of goods, we will receive cash account debit. We are selling goods of 10,000, but we will receive more cash because we will charge GST also from him. So we will receive GST also from him. So cash account debit to sales, the amount of sale is 8,000 only. Now in earlier case, when we purchasing, we are paying GST. This GST we are paying. Now we will receive GST in case of sale from the purchaser. To output CGST to output SGST account. How much amount that we need to charge from our purchaser? That is 9% of the gross value. Gross value is 8000. 9% of 8000 is 720. Then 720 will go to the central government and 720 will go to the state government. And total we will charge from that customer. That is 9440. So this amount we will charge from our customer. We are selling goods to him only of amount 8000, but he need to pay GST also, so we are charging GST from him. We need to pay that GST to central government, so we do not have any profit or any type of facility from that GST. But it is because we also paid GST to someone when we are purchasing goods, so we need to charge it from our customer also, so we can set up the amount that we paid and remaining amount we will pay to the government. Our next entry is on April 8. In this case, purchase goods from Karam for 10,000 plus CGST and SGST at the rate 9%. This is also a purchase entry. Now we are purchasing from Karam. Purchase account debit. The amount of the goods that we are purchasing is 10,000. In case of purchase, we need to pay GST. So we will pay GST first. Input how much? 9%. Input CGST account debit. Input SGST account debit to Karam. First transaction of purchase we have in cash. They clearly mentioned that we are purchasing good in cash for 5000, but in this entry they do not mention about the transaction that we are doing in cash or through check. So we will take it as credit transaction because we are purchasing from Karam. So we taken it is at the name we put of the vendor, that is Karam. So the GST amount of this transaction is 9%. Then it will go 900 and 900. So we need to pay 18% of total amount, 9% for state government and 9% for central government. So the total percentage of GST is 18% also, but it go half to the central and half go to the state government, and we need to pay total amount to the Karam. But here we having a entry of credit transaction, so we will put it in the name of Karam, not in cash or bank. So we need to put total amount to the Karam, that is 11,800. So it's easy to post the entries in case of GST because you need to just check whether it is purchase or whether it is sale. In case of purchase, we are using input with purchase, and in case of sale, we are using output because in case of purchase, we pay the GST, and in case of sale, we receive the GST from customer. After this, another entry we have on April 15. That is sold goods to Param for 15,000 plus CGST and SGST 9% each. Now we are selling goods to Param, but they do not mention in whether in cash or whether through bank. So we will take it as credit transaction, and for credit transaction, we use name instead of cash or bank. So the entry will go in the name of Param. So Param account debit. And other thing I need to tell that is account, that in front of name we do not use account again. Param account debit, Param debit to sales account to output SGST to output CGST. The amount of sale is 15,000. The amount of sale is 15,000. The rate of taxation is also 9% each for the state and for central. So the 9% of 15,000 is 1315. 1315 for state, and the total will go in the upper column in the debit in front of name of Param because we need to receive that amount from Param because we are selling goods to Param on the credit basis. So in this entry also, it is same as we have entry on April 1st. In April 1st, we are purchasing good on credit basis. On April 15, we are selling goods on credit basis. But the charging of GST is same. In case of purchase, we use input. In case of sale, we use output. So our next entry is April 20. April 20. Goods returned by the Param of ₹5,000 being defective. Till now, we are only having purchase and sale. So, in case of purchase and sale, we are paying and receiving GST. But when someone return our goods or someone has, or we return goods to someone, there is a reverse of GST also in that case. In this case, goods returned by Param and Param is our debtor whom we sold goods of 15,000. He returned goods of worth as 5,000. So we received good back. So in case of receiving goods back, the entry is of sales return. That is sales return account debit. Now the GST that we charged from the Param, we need to reverse it. For reversing, we will put when we charge that was in credit. Now, when we need to reverse it, we will put in debit. So, output SGST account debit output CGST account debit to Param. In case of return, we need just to reverse the entry. So we are reversing this entry. And the amount is 5,000 amount, five worth of 5,000 we received back from Param. That is 5,000. Now we need to reverse the GST also that we received earlier from him. For 1350 for state government and 1315 for central government. Now we need to reverse it to back. So how much value worth of goods we are receiving back? That is 5,000. So 9% of 5,000 is 450 for both. And the total amount that we need to reverse is 5,900. When there is a sale return, when there is a purchase return, we need to reverse the GST also because we charged GST from them when we are selling the whole amount. लेट्स टेक एन एग्जाम्पल, अगर मैं 10,000 के गुड्स बेच रहा हूँ और मैंने उस पर 4% जीएसटी लिया है, मीन्स मैंने 400 रुपये का जीएसटी लिया है, लेकिन उस 10,000 में से मेरे को 2,000-5,000 के गुड्स वापिस आ गए हैं उस बंदे से, तो मेरे को जो मैंने 400 रुपये जीएसटी उससे लिया था 10,000 पे, उसमें से मेरे को वो आधा जीएसटी उसको वापिस करना होगा 200 रुपये का, बिकॉज नाउ आई एम ओनली एबल टू चार्ज जीएसटी ओनली दैट अमाउंट दैट इज 5,000। मुझे सिर्फ उस 5,000 का जीएसटी रखना है जो गुड्स उसने रख लिए, और जो गुड्स उसने मुझे वापस कर दिया है उसका जीएसटी भी मुझे उसको रिटर्न करना पड़ेगा। नाउ वी हैव अनदर एंट्री ऑन अप्रैल 25, दैट इज रिटर्न गुड्स परचेज्ड फ्रॉम करम कॉस्टिंग 4,000। अर्लियर वी परचेज गुड्स फ्रॉम करम ऑल्सो ऑफ 10,000 रुपीज, एंड वी गिवन जीएसटी एंड एसजीएसटी 9% ईच टू करम। दैट इज ऑल्सो अ क्रेडिट ट्रांजेक्शन दैट वी परचेज गुड्स फ्रॉम करम, बट नाउ करम, नाउ वी आर रिटर्निंग गुड्स टू करम ऑफ रुपीज 4,000। सो इन अर्ली एंट्री, इन सेल्स एंट्री, वी स्टडीड दैट इन केस ऑफ सेल रिटर्न वी नीड टू गिव बैक द जीएसटी टू द पर्सन होम वी आर सेलिंग गुड्स और होम वी रिसीव्ड आवर गुड्स बैक, बट इन केस ऑफ परचेज रिटर्न वी ऑल्सो रिसीव जीएसटी बैक फ्रॉम दैट पर्सन होम वी परचेज गुड्स अर्लियर। सो नाउ इन केस ऑफ परचेज रिटर्न ऑल्सो वी नीड टू रिवर्स द एंट्री फॉर परचेज रिटर्न, एंड द एंट्री विल गो इन द नेम ऑफ करम अकाउंट, करम डेबिट टू परचेज रिटर्न अकाउंट टू इनपुट CGST टू इनपुट SGST अकाउंट। हाउ मच वर्थ ऑफ गुड्स वी आर रिटर्निंग टू करम, दैट इज 4,000। वी नीड टू पुट इन द फ्रंट ऑफ परचेज रिटर्न 4,000 वर्थ रुपीज ऑफ गुड वी आर रिटर्निंग हिम, एंड द जीएसटी दैट वी विल रिसीव बैक दैट इज 9% ऑफ 4,000, दैट इज 360। टोटल अमाउंट ऑफ गुड्स रिटर्न दैट इज 4,720। सो दिस इज हाउ वी पोस्ट एंट्री इन केस ऑफ परचेज रिटर्न ऑल्सो। इन केस ऑफ सेल रिटर्न वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग जीएसटी बैक टू द पर्सन होम वी सोल्ड द गुड्स अर्लियर, बट नाउ व्हेन वी आर रिटर्निंग टू गुड्स समवन वी विल ऑल्सो रिसीव बैक अवर जीएसटी दैट वी पेड टू दैट पर्सन इन इन केस व्हेन वी आर परचेजिंग गुड्स फ्रॉम हिम, बिकॉज वी आर ऑल्सो नाउ रिटर्निंग गुड्स टू हिम, सो वी ऑल्सो हैव टू रिसीव अवर जीएसटी बैक फ्रॉम दैट पर्सन। सो अवर नेक्स्ट एंट्री इज फॉर अप्रैल 30, दैट इज कैश सेल ऑफ रुपीज 10,000 चार्जिंग जीएसटी एंड एसजीएसटी एट 9% ईच। सो इट इज वेरी सिंपल एंट्री दैट वी आर सेलिंग गुड्स ऑफ रुपीज 10,000 एंड चार्जिंग सीजीएसटी एंड एसजीएसटी ऑफ 9% ईच, एंड अदर थिंग इज दैट वी आर रिसीविंग कैश। सो एंट्री विल गो ऑन अप्रैल 30, एंड द एंट्री इज कैश अकाउंट डेबिट टू सेल्स अकाउंट टू CGST दैट इज आउटपुट एंड टू आउटपुट SGST अकाउंट। हाउ मच वर्थ ऑफ गुड्स वी आर सेलिंग दैट इज 10,000। वी आर सेलिंग गुड्स ऑफ रुपीज 10,000 एंड द रेट ऑफ GST इज 9% ईच सेम, दैट इज 900 एंड 900। सो द टोटल अमाउंट दैट वी नीड टू रिसीव फ्रॉम दैट पर्सन इज 11,800। सो इन ऑल दीज एंट्री वॉट वी हैव डन दैट इन केस ऑफ परचेज वी विल पे GST दैट इज 9% और 10% वट एवर इट इज गिवन इन द ट्रांजेक्शन, बट इफ देयर इज ओनली अ सिंगल ट्रांजेक्शन गिवन दैट वी परचेज गुड फ्रॉम समवन एंड पेड 18% ऑफ GST टू हिम, इट मीन्स वी इफ दे गिवन द स्लैब रेट दैट इज 18% एंड वी नीड टू डिवाइड इट इन हाफ ऑफ टू सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, बट इफ दे गिवन क्लियरली दैट दे हैव इट GST slab rate 9% for each. It means 9% for central and 9% for state government. Because we know we have only the limited slab rates for GST, that is 5%, 12%, 18% and 28%. So if someone given that that they charging 30% GST from someone, that is the wrong slab rate and we will not charge that because it is a wrong question or wrong transaction because it is not even in the curriculum of GST. And it clearly mentioned in GST that we have only 5 slab rates. We can't charge other than these slab rates. So in case of cash sale, we will receive amount immediately. But in case of credit transaction, we will put the name of that person whom we will need, who we will receive money later. So all these entry we have to find input and output GST. In this, we in case of purchase, we will get the credit of input, and in case of sale, we will get the paper output that is payable to the central government. So in next video, we will discuss about the setup of input and output GST and implementation of IGST. IGST is for interstate transaction and CGST and SGST for intrastate transaction. Intrastate transaction, the transaction that happened within the state and the transaction that happened out of the state or between the two states, that in that case we will charge IGST. So how to set up of the amount of input and output of all threes, IGST, CGST and SGST, we will study it in our next video.